Okay, the first case that I want to look at today is the perpendicular polarized case. For the perpendicular polarized case, that means that the electric field is perpendicular to the plane of incidence or perpendicular to the blackboard. Last time we decided that if we put our thumb in the direction of K, our finger in the direction of E, our third finger would show us the direction of H. That's considered H perpendicular, even though, of course, H is parallel to the board. It's still for the perpendicularly polarized electric field case. Here we have our incident angle, theta I. If you look at the geometry here, you can see that theta I also ends up right here. So we're going to use geometry, just angles, to be able to define the polarization of H and E. I've defined a set of vectors here. I've said that this direction is z, that's approximately the propagation direction, and x is up out of the board this way. So if we wanted to find y, we would do our finger in the direction of x, our thumb in the direction of z, our third finger would show us which way y is. Y is out of the board in this case. So let's use that to write the polarization for the electric and the magnetic field. The electric field for the perpendicularly polarized case is going to have some magnitude, E, and in this case we can see that it's Y, because it's coming out like the Y direction, EY incident, and that's strictly a magnitude. And then it's going to be multiplied by the polarization. In this case, it is Y polarized. Now let's look at the magnetic field. The magnetic field for the perpendicular case is going to have a magnitude, which I'm going to leave blank for now. Let's find its polarization. It's going to have some polarization in the z direction and some polarization in the x direction. If it is opposite our angle, that's the sine. So this is sine of theta I, and over here would be cosine of theta I. So we can see that the polarization for the magnetic field is going to be in the positive z direction, sine of theta I. So I'm going to write this a little differently. Let's be sure we've got our x's first. In the z direction, it's sine of theta I, and in the x direction, we're going in the negative x direction because we're going down and the positive x direction is going up. So it is negative x direction cosine of theta I. So there's the polarization for the magnetic field for the incident case. So here's incident, here is incident. Let's also write it for the reflected case. Now, as we go through this reflection, the electric field polarization does not change. So right here is our reflected electric field. Also, when it transmits, the polarization of the electric field does not change. So we can see that for all of these, in fact, I'm going to write them right here, the reflected field is going to have a magnitude, ER, and it's going to be in the y direction, and the transmitted electric field is going to have some magnitude, and that's also going to be in the y direction. But the magnetic field, we have to look at again our right-hand rule. So if I put my thumb in the direction of propagation and my finger in the direction of E, I can see that the magnetic field is going to go up on the board like this. So here is HR. Right here, this angle would be theta R. So we can see that we're going to have a z and a positive x component for the reflected magnetic field vector. Let's write it here. Here's our reflected vector. It's going to have some magnitude that we'll look at later. And then let's do the polarization. So we can see that the z component is going to be sine of theta I, and that's the z vector. And in the x direction, it's positive x this time, cosine of theta I. Now let's look at the transmitted field. Here's the direction of propagation. Here's my electric field. My magnetic field is going down on the board. Here is HT. Right here, this is theta T. So we've got a positive Z and a negative X component. Let's write that here. H transmitted has a magnitude, and then it has a negative X direction, cosine of theta I, plus a positive z direction, sine of theta I. Oops, and excuse me, these are theta t's, and these are theta r's, but theta r and theta I are equal. So that's given us the polarization of all six of the vectors that are in our picture. The next thing that we're going to analyze is going to be the direction of propagation of each of these plane waves.